In the last video, I pointed out the first position major scale. Before I go on to the other major scales, I would like to explain the circle of fifths. The circle of fifths is a very important principle in music, and especially for the harmonica player, since the positions on the harmonica are numbered according to the circle of fifths. Last time I spoke about the C scale, C, D, E, F, G, A, D, C. If we place C on top of the circle here, then we have no flats, no sharps. If we go clockwise in the circle, we go up a fifth. So we start on C, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. C, D, E, F, G. G is the fifth of C. So that is the next key in the circle. If we go clockwise, every step we make, we add one sharp. And the sharp gets added on the seventh of the next key. So the seventh of the key of G. If we keep on counting from G, we go G, A, B, C, D, E. F is the seventh. That turns into F sharp. So we get G, A, B, C, D, E, F sharp, G. The next key, again, is a fifth up from G. So that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. G, A, B, C, D. That has two sharps. The second sharp occurs on the seventh, which is the C sharp. I'll get to the details of the scales later. For now, I'll just quickly go through a few keys. From D, we have D, E, F sharp, which we already had, G, A, B, C sharp, D. So the fifth from that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. D, E, F sharp, G, A. If we go counterclockwise, we go down a fifth. So if we have the C scale, C, D, E, F, G, A, B, C, we go down 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That is C, B, A, G, F. So F is the next. If we go counterclockwise, and when we go this way, we don't add sharps, but we add flats. So F has one flat. And if you go clockwise, you add a sharp to the seventh of the key you're going to. And if you go counterclockwise, you add a flat to the seventh, the key you came from. So you have the C scale, C, D, E, F, G, A, B. This B is the seventh, and that gets flatted to B flat. So in the new key of F, that is F, G, A, B flat, C, D, E, F. We make another step, we go down 5 from F, F, that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, F, E, D, C, B flat. So the new key is B flat, which has two flats, and the new flat occurs on what was the 7th of the key of F, and that turns into E flat. So the scale of B flat becomes B flat, C, D, E flat, F, G, A, B flat. As I said, I'll be getting back to those scales later. I'll finish the circle just for now. Here we go. E, that is B, F sharp, and on this side we get E flat, A flat, D flat. You could say here, and I have a G flat. That's right, in harmonics. How do you use this circle? First of all, the positions are numbered in this circle. If you have a C harmonica, then, and you start on C, this is first position, G is second position, D third position, A fourth position, E fifth position. And the other way around, you have a C harmonica, and F is first flat position, B flat is second flat position. That works all the way around. If you have an A harmonica, then E is second position, B is third position. Another thing that also works is that if you have a blues, which has a 1, 4, 5, and if you pick a key, say D, if that is 1, then the 4 and the 5 are on either side of it. So A is 5, and G is 4. So also for figuring out your blues chords, this circle is really, really convenient. Well, that's it. I'll get back to the scales now.